fund për neve një ishtë parat.
No, it's a skirt. It's a skirt, no. Right? No? What's
no,
fund?
No.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, really?
It's your fjalat.
Oh, it's fundi, a bad word.
Fundi për neve ishtë dias.
Bitha. Bitha, okay. Yeah.
No. New fund, di bitha.
Di bitha, di fund.
You can say also fund spien.
Okay.
Spine in the end of fund spien.
Falem, we am Lidia Cucha, who leva in Buenos Aires, Argentina, ka prindra Arbresh, di kapiana degli Albanesi, e nani jam in Canada.
Emrim ishte Peter, de Lade, me thone dhe Petros, e u lejshe de Londino, dhe dhe Angli. Me një këshiu jam Anglo-Vretano, me më dhe tata e u dane, edhe para tata im ishte shkleror, me singe një arberor. Dhe katund, fliz në hep arberishte, e për të zish një gluhe, preps të kesh njerës për të flasësh.
Ju shëndetit të gjithve, quhem Viktor Angoni, Viktor Angoni Liopoulos, vin nga Greqia. Baba im është grek, nëna ime është shqiptare nga Gjirokastra. Jam folës si dialektit Tosk. Kam studiuar për balkanologji në Universitetin e Karolit në Prag. Dhe kaq, po bëjmë kërkime mbi gjuhën shqipe.
Përshëndetje, quhem Aziz Duka. Kam lindur në Dibër, por jetoj në Tiranë. Mund kuptohet Dibrançe, por nuk e flas tamam, nuk flas as Dibrançe as Tiranëse, por shqipen standarde. Që do mundohem flas shqipen standarde.
Më thon Pasquale, jam ka ferma, i Rom, jam student. Flas arbërisht firmjot, jam ka ferma që është në katundi provincës Calabrisë të Kosenzis.
Unë jam Roland Uruqi, jemi lindu në Dibër Madhe, u është në anën e Macedonisë, në Dibër Avogl është në anën e Shqipnisë. Jem kam ardhë në Amerikë, është në 3 vjetë me familjen tem, edhe jem rejtë në Amerikë, edhe folit ma shumë Dibrançe sa dialekt atjera.
Përshëndetje të gjithë, jam Visar Tasimi, ndodhem në Shtetet Bashkuara të Amerikës në Connecticut. Jam brezi I dytë shqiptaro-amerikan, jam unë vetë I lindur këtu edhe mamaja e lindur këtu në Amerikë. Me preardhje jemi nga Prespa e Macedonisë, po me preardhjen të vjetër familjare jemi nga Kolonja dhe besoj që gjua ime do jetë më e prafërt me Viktorin, po jam I vetë mësuar shqip, nuk kam ndjekur shkollë ose edukim shqiptare, po gjithashtu faleminderit për ftesën.
Murtiri paler e brekt prer. Murtiri paler e brekt prer.
Okay, so who thinks they understood? Okay, Visa.
No, nuk e kuptova. Plot, po pjesën e dytë, brek, në me thënë, breke, të prera, e para ishte murtiri, murë.
Murtiri.
Murë e pa lyë.
Një fjalë vetëm, murtiri.
Murtiri.
Pa.
Pa lyë. Okay.
E brekt prerë.
Pjesa e dytë është kuptueshme besoj. Por pjesa e parë, pjesën e parë nuk e kuptojmë dot.
You said multiri, right?
Multiri, multiri.
Multiri. So the first thing I'm thinking of is the wall. Does it mean wall? No, it doesn't.
Jo, jo.
Is it the mile like muliri?
Yes.
Muliri. Okay.
Muliri.
Okay.
Pa, ishte mund të spjegar? ishte një mugiri, ma gjin e burri që shërbente mugiri.
Oh, okay.
Burri okay. që shërbente mugiri.
Okay, so once again, please, multiri.
Multiri pa ler e brekt prer.
Is brekt pants, pantalon.
Yes. Gjiu I pa lar dhe brekt prer. Palar, he isn't washed.
No.
No?
Ler, no lar. Ler.
He left. Maybe he left.
No, he isn't no. born yet. He isn't born yet.
Esempio. Uleva te marzi. Viesti vui te marzi. Murtiri pa ler.
Unborn.
He isn't born yet.
He's not born. Okay.
He's not born yet.
Ebrecht prer.
I have a preposition with an English explanation. I don't know if I'm going to get it. Does it mean, is the meaning of this proverb that we do things when it's very, very early? It's not time to do things yet? Okay.
Excellent, excellent.
Okay. Bravo, yes, bravo.
Because you see, the person has not been born and his pants are already being cut and sewed.
So, see? Okay, yeah. Hemmed. Okay.
Song.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Very good. Interesting.
Very good. Good job.
Good job.
Molonari palier tirchite prer, però gekishka gjurmai.
So you brektik I thrini tirke.
Mm.
Ah. Na tirkian socks.
Ah. For never.
Përneve janë tirki janë
yeah. sops. Brek përneve janë rachet mbrenqme. Underwear. Si underwear.
Ah, no, no, underwear is brek të linda.
Jo, brek të janë përfujnë, rachet përfujnë. Ja, ja është brek për ne. Për qatë në baron pak.
Fund përneve janë ishtë parat.
No, it's a skirt. It's a skirt, no. right? No? What's food?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, really?
It's your calats.
It's a bad word.
Fundi puneve ishte dias.
Bitha. Bitha, okay.
Yeah. New font, di bitha.
Di bitha, di fundi. New font, di bitha.
You can say also font spin.
Okay. Yes,
spine, in the end, font spin.
Oh.
Naftua new film e kursosi film I shkruaj fundi I filmit e i me motre muma e u ju vrejtum e ju mund kishun besë kishun shkruar tu fjalatse e filmi fundi I filmit
esatto
that's funny, that's funny.
Kasidjari kur zulesh, I buksule në devesh.
I understood devesh, in the ears, in the ear.
That's right.
No, right. Ha, kasul.
Ah,
no,
yeah, yeah.
Kasule, no. Kalesh.
Kur zulesh, I buksule në devesh.
So, wool hat, kasul me lesh. That's a wool hat. Please, chilesh, right?
Yeah, chilesh.
And repeat the second half. I'm sorry, Peter. Can you repeat the second half?
Kasidjari kur zulesh, I vuksulene devesh.
E parafjal që ish?
Cilja është parafjal?
Parafjal? Ah, kasidjari.
Ka?
Kasidjari.
Kasidjari.
Two words?
No.
Kasidjari.
Kasidjari.
I'm going to be the last one to comment this because I think I totally understand it because of the Greek influence, so I'm out of this.
So I would say that kasule for me is a hood.
Okay.
Not a hat.
Oh, for us, it would be a cool hat. For
in,
us.
In Dibr Madhe, kasule, yeah. they say in the cartons. In the city, we say kapelle.
Mm. Yeah, the same.
But the cartons, they all say kasule. So my wife's family is from the Caton, they say kasul. actually. That's the only reason I know the word, because they say ksul.
Yeah. You would say kapello, in which is the Greek word, and ksul is the traditional. Actually, the Western traditional outfit.
Yeah, it's a ksul.
Briftika kaksula. So the hat is also the
headdress.
The priest's hat is also ksula.
Por mua ksula ishte si një kopuh, që ishte një shurbet që vetë të tivu të kryet të rishën ngrohtë, non një shurbet që të vitë të kryet pudierin, ma një shurbet të undu që të tivu gjithështu e të rishën ngrohtë, ishte e meleshë, bunet meleshë.
Well, maybe I should give you a hint, though. So kasidiari is somebody who there's two things that it could be. One is bald, somebody who's bald, although kasidiari is bald because of a certain illness. So it's like bits of hair. So the kasidiari is somebody who has bits of hair. And we have quite a few in our proverbs. Kasidiari is quite a figure. So kasidiari is bald. Kurzulesh I vuksulen devesh. Kurzulesh.
When he grew his hair, he didn't need his hat anymore, so he stuck it in his ear?
Not quite. So shall I let the cat out of the bag, or shall I let Victor maybe say it?
Actually, Visar, it's really close to the real meaning. Kasidiar, except of a bald man, it can mean proud man who shouldn't be proud, something like this. So he reached his achievement, he makes a big deal out of his achievement, Zulesh, like finally he has hair, and then he puts the hat on the ear. I'm not pretty sure about the last part.
So when you put ksula devesh, instead of putting the ksula this way, you wear it this way to show the hair that is there. So
to show that finally I got
Kurzulesh, okay. So it's a thing, as you said, it's being loud, proud, and strutting around.
Yeah. Should I get? I'm gonna get my kasul. Should I?
It would be like being a show off.
Yes. Yeah. Kurzulesh. Yes. See, in Dibrançe, lesh also means pubic hair. So, the Zolish, that means you became an adult in Dibrançe. Zolish. That's what it means. That's what it means. That's when you became a man. Kezan Lish, Lish.
Buddy math.
Yeah.
And in standard, it can also mean something meaningless.
Yes.
That's even like a slang. When you don't like somebody, you call me Lish. You call. So somebody
that shows off, that's the meaning.
Yeah. Yeah. Ah, the Zolish. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That means, now you essentially, I mean, I don't, it's like saying, oh, you finally became a man now, like you're bragging.
Kush nën ka shtëpi, nën ka gjitoni. Kapirti? Gjegje.
Repeat it slower.
Kush nën ka shtëpi, nën ka gjitoni.
Kush është ka shtëpia, ka dituni? Ka dituni?
Jo.
Jo.
Kush nën ka shtëpi?
Po.
Nën ka gjitoni.
Who doesn't have a house, doesn't have a neighbor? Maybe or not?
Yeah.
Okay.
Bravo.
Bravo. Nice.
Nice. Because I live in Tirana, I don't use the word gitani, but gitani is a Tosk word, is for neighbor. To use the word komshi. Komshi.
Oh. Yeah, I think komshi, yeah.
Okay. Komshi, koishi. But the word is Tosk. I just know it from, because I live in Tirana, but we don't use it a lot in Dibra.
Yeah. And Pascal, does that mean that you should first take care of your house and then take care of other people? Is this the meaning of the proverb? Mm-hmm. Okay, in Greek, it's really close. So, the Greek proverb is, if you don't take care of the house, it will collapse on top of you. So it's pretty close. But anyway.
You do not use it?
Never heard it.
We do. Sorry, I get confused. We do.
You do use it, yeah. And Visar doesn't use it.
We don't use it. Komşi. We say komşi. And...
Komşi from Turkish. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, we in Gjirokastriot, we use equally all three. We are very diplomats. We say fqin, komshi, gjiton, all of them.
Puna e rinis, jorgan i pleqëris.
U kapir të gjë. Shurbirit të ti që i re, është gjë. Kur je pjak, të kapirte. Per unë mangon dhe një fjall.
Yeah, the work you do when you are a youth person, it will be your quill of old age, or blanket. It will help you to live a better life when you be old. The work you do when you are young, it will help you in old age. Puna is a work. Rinis is a youth. Jorgan is pleqëris, but jorgan is a Turkish word, it's not Turkish origin word. So
organ.
Jorgan.
Jorgan.
Yeah, jorgan.
I pleqëris.
Yeah, in English it would be like quilt or a blanket. I don't know how to say
it. Duvet. It's a duvet.
Duvet.
What?
Jorgan.
Duvet.
Yeah, it's a duvet with a blanket inside it, like a quilt inside. It's the cover. That's a jorgan.
Exactly the word in English, but...
yeah.
Okay, because puna, we say shupertira. Rinis, I don't know that word.
Rinia?
Yeah.
Rinia? No?
Yeah.
Iri? Iri means...
Iri e thomina. Ne thom iri, quindi mund arrivofet.
Iri. And rinia is the age when you are young.
Iri, puneve... New ishte young, ishte
new, but is it young for us?
We don't use iri for people. We say ishte kopil, ishte new kopil.
Kopil is a bad word.
I know.
Oh, I can't wait to come to Italy and call people copil.
No,
yeah, everywhere, yeah. This is specific to one katond in Dibr. Katond. Jur bohet mor. You can, Lydia, just hit unmute.
I totally got it, but I will not say it. I totally
okay. Okay.
I don't know why, but I think that in Arberisht, in our dialect, we would say, Dale dal bunet mushum. No?
Dale dal? No. But it, I mean, sort of. Yes, Peter.
I think what we say in Arvanitika, we say fasule, fasule, plonit e sekule. Like one beating after the other fills the...
Po. But kjo është gjur, shtëpoja bëhet me gjur.
Gur me gur.
Po ja bëhet me gjur. Rruga bëhet me gjur. Po, jo, bë gjur. Çfarë është gjur? E marrë që vesh është gjur?
So, stone by stone.
Po. Gur me gur. Dibra në qytet thojnë gur, gur. Në katond thojnë gjur. Në katond ku vije dukat, ku vin dukat, spasi, thonë që unë jam vander ke duka. Unë jam vander dukash. Edhe ato thojnë gjur.
In a lot of words on Dibra is like, for example, djath, gjath.
Yeah, we say gjath. We silence a lot of letters.
Yeah, for the finger, for example, is gishti, gishti.
Yeah, depends, yeah.
Where is g, is g. In something like that in Dibra. It's different. Yeah.
Get rid of those j's.
I love, we got a lot of j's. We got a lot. We say moir. We don't say mir. We say moir. So, but we have a silent H. Dibrançe also almost always loses the H in everything. Prahan. Hana. Hana? We say Hana.
The moon.
Moon, yeah. We say Hana. We say Hana. But we say Hana, it's very soft.
What do you say to walk?
Ets.
Ets.
Ets. Ets.
Okay, cool.
Oh, ets. Yeah.
We have the same thing too. Like H's are almost non-existent.
Yes, yeah, sure.
Of like for a key,
yeah.
Opse, we would just say opse.
Yes, nothing dri, drini.
This is a common thing in standard Albanian as well. There are many H's that become colloquially silent, like the word father-in-law. Theoretically, it's vjehër, but no one says that. Everyone says vjehër. But in Gjirokastria, we have only one word where we put an additional H where we shouldn't. We say hets. Don't say hets. Say hets. Hets. Okay. Like go away, walk off, which is weird. Anyway, Lydia, by the way, I think her proverb is the same in terms of meaning. What she said, dal, dal, bëhet më shumë. Can you repeat that, Lydia?
Dale, dal, bunet më shumë.
So I think in terms of meaning, it's an equivalent proverb.
Mm-hmm. But what is more in...
wall.
Wall?
Wall, the wall.
Ah, yeah, man,
yeah, we say more. We don't say more, we say more.
More.
More, M-O-R, more.
We say levy. I don't know if that's Albanian or
levy. And also we muri.
Muri, muri.
Muri. No, muri.
Dale, dal, guret, muri. Oh.
Oh.
Gure, gur.
Gur, gur, bot, mur. Bot, mur.
Gur, gur.
This one will probably be too easy for Victor and Haziz and probably Rodan too, but. Let's see. It's a lot of words, but I'll say it slowly. Mua më digjet mjekra, ti më thua ndizma cigaren.
I understood mua më digjet mjekra. Mua më digjet mjekra. My beard burns me.
Muam digjet mjekra, my bird flames. And can you repeat?
The second part is
yeah.
Ti më thua ndizma okay. Cigaren.
To you say me the I don't know.
You got it. Like my cigarette.
Okay.
Wow. How say again very slowly?
Okay, I'll say it slowly. Mua më digjet mjekra, ti më thua ndizma cigaren. So
okay.
Literally, my beard is on fire and you're asking me for a light, like my cigarette.
That's really cool.
So it's like asking an inappropriate question, you know, like you have a big issue at hand and someone is asking something that is completely irrelevant or tone deaf to what your issue is. You know, literally, my beard is on fire and you're saying, hold still, let me light my cigarette.
Yeah, nice. And Pasquale got straight away.
There is an equivalent proverb. There is an equivalent proverb in standard Albanian, but it includes a swear word. So I don't know if I'm allowed to say it.
Oh yeah, that was my second one.
Okay.
But Cosme digete the pliaka krihete.
You got it, Peter.
Oh, that was great. I love that it went really quickly and from the furthest away dialect as well. So that's really cool.
Can I try one more? I do have to go. It's along the same lines of
Sure, go on. Yeah.
More simple Albanian. Okay. I'll use the one with the bad word in it. And again, same group, you guys will probably get it right away. Fluturon shqiponja në maj të malit, fluturon dhe miza në byth të kalit.
Everybody got it. You're the winner.
You're on mute.
The perfect Balkan sarcasm.
Dhe mune se Shqiponia unë ju di që ishtë, ma më duke se ka jetë like a butterfly or something like that, a bird that flies high in the top of the mountain, but the misa, which is the fly, only can fly on the muti to call it, the bifa to call it. So, meaning, if you are a higher person, you will fly high, but if you are not a high, if you are a low person, you will always be down. Is that the meaning?
Yeah. So Shqiponja is the Shqiponja, the Albanian.
Yes.
We call Ikura.
Ikura, way, Ikura. Porque isso Shqip tal. Okay.
No, I was just going to say I do have to run because I'm supposed to be in another meeting. But please invite me next time if you have another
okay.
one.
Okay, that's fine.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Nice meeting you.
You too.
So I'm going to start with proverbs that are actually, I have three. I don't know if we have time to get through all three. The first one, before even I say it, I need to make a disclaimer because there is no way you will get it. The last word is a microtoponym. It's a little small region outside Gjirokastra, my hometown. So don't think what word is that. So the proverb goes like this. Haro muske valaren. Haro muske valaren. And valare, it's the name of a region.
Mm-hmm. Haro, forget it. Mm-hmm. Muske, yes. The mule.
Mm-hmm.
The female donkey, mm-hmm. I think.
Yes.
Valaren.
Valare, this region. Yeah, what does that mean? Someone who wants to try?
I think that what means is that it is not important to worry about that. It's something that is not important. No.
Okay. I'm going to help you. Muska is the subject. So, and Haro is imperative. So you talk to Muska. Haro Muska Valagen.
Yeah, forget now that you're in town, forget the village because you need to be a little bit more elegant.
Nope.
It's a little town. You said it's a little town.
No, it's not a town. It's just fields. Oh. It's a micro toponym. Yeah.
Oh, no.
I think it may be that the mule forget about this town, so you should try to speak the topic you have with a person that will hear you and understand it and remember it, not to someone that will immediately forget about it. So you speak to the mule about the town and she forgot about it.
Mm-mm. Maybe not. Because, maybe, sorry. The proverb has a very specific rhythm. We say "Haro muske valagen," but correctly in Albanian, the stress should be "Haro muske valagen." So "muske Haro valagen," it's imperative.
Maybe një më I bgat do mushken, ashtu kat harron the poverty.
Not exactly.
Okay. Sorry.
This is hard. No one
can share like this
stuff. I'm going to give a last hint. This is something that definitely a parent will say to its children when they want to ask a lot. When they ask a lot.
So forget about it. Yes. It's nothing.
It's not going to happen. Forget about it. It's not going to happen. Bye-bye the old good days. Yeah, it was really difficult. Maybe because Valare outside Gjirokastra used to be a field which was really prosperous for animals, and Mushk, they really like going there. So you talk to the mushk and you're like, forget about this nice place.
Yeah. Okay. Right.
Yes.
Interesting. Okay.
That was difficult. And I'm going to say a second one because yes. I got to leave as well. This is really easy because there is an equivalent to standard Albanian. But it's the Gjirokastriot version. It has two Turkish words. So the Italian group, I'm not really sure. So it says, Puna me ortak, dhe byfa në sokak.
Okay.
Shupërtire me
byfa
të stratuca, like the small road.
Yes, yes, yeah. It is.
But I didn't get the ortak.
Ortak. Okay, all the Albanians from Albania got it. So ortak in Turkish, it means working together with a partner. It's a partner. So puna me ortak, dhe byfa në sokak.
Okay.
Roland.
I didn't get that word. I don't know ortak. I got everything ortak. But ortak.
It's yeah. A partner. It's
yeah,
a partner.
I never do that. Yeah. I got the modern Albanian, partneri. That's what we say. So, I never heard that expression. Interesting.
Peter, maybe you want to guess what that means? Petrio?
I mean, don't trust your partners. That's what it means.
Yes, pretty close. Pretty close. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to give the standard Albanian version, which is Puna Bashk, the Bytha Jasht.
Oh, yeah.
It means that when you work with... It's really safer when you work on your own. For example, you have your own business. If you work with your brother or with someone else, things might go really wrong. Yeah. So that's the meaning.
Ftet. Oh. It's true.
Yeah.
There is an expression in our Arberisht that says bashkiaret. Mm. E drungoni, bashk. Bashkiaret. Cioè, to bashk meaning together. Bashkiaret. So meaning it's better to work on your own than to work with other people. It's the same idea.
Mm-hmm.
Bashk bashkiaret.
Very interesting. Bashk bashkiaret. Nice.
Interesting.
Cornieri ca crie that, e bun strumba ca chesh o biset parach, a ie me gaidur se gaiduri.
I understand. Cornieri ca mending that, a dried head. That just means he's not, he has nothing in his head, empty head. That's, I know that. And what was the second part of that?
E bun strumba ca chesh.
Crooked.
Shurbiset parach.
He only works for that.
He works for money.
Shurbitet,
it's not about money or
work.
Shurbet,
what's he said?
Shurbet.
Yeah, it's real.
Shurbiset is not work.
Work, okay.
No. Shurben is I work, but Shurbiset. Is the plural of shurbes, which is things.
Things?
Objects.
Bengacher shurbise parach. Parach? Nobody's going to understand parach. Right? Parach means the same.
Parach to us means until that point. Parach. We say that. In Dibrançe, we say, I work for that.
Oh, interesting.
In Dibrançe, we say parach.
Okay, so Cornieri ca crie that, e bun strumbur. He does everything crookedly.
Crooked, yeah.
Gahes shurbiset parach. So he does everything the same.
Yeah, for that. For that, up to that. There's a parach means there's a boundary.
Oh,
Thomas said, we say.
Ilur.
What's Ilur?
It's the donkey. It's Gajdhuri is Gomar.
Oh, Gomar.
Ah,
okay.
Ah, Gomar. Yeah.
Okay. Exactly.
There's a bigger donkey.
So everyone got it eventually?
I got it. Yeah, and I got most of it. Yeah. We say Magar for Gomar.
Magar, Magar.
Magar.
Magar, Magar, Gomar.
That's yeah. Gomar, yeah, for us. Yeah. We say Magar.
Gajdhuri.
Escute, o nu e drungova.
Aia?
No. Cum unde tu așa, mă? Cu ce sa? Ti, o, u e drungova, o, ma, por que isso? No, ishe pensaria tu cazien, allora. Tu e, tu a, kishkishu mungrune, ja? Cam timșoche, repetită. Ka si thu shinoni kam një hivuh ishe pincaja që kishë zieja harrova se kishë falur ti o u e drungova mir
amen
fora mos diu për që një dejhe
exactly okay I think that's everybody's phrases so we could leave it there and if everybody likes we can do again another
Oh yeah, because I can't help others.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, for the timing. Yeah, how do you say see you soon? I say
Chef me prap.
Prap.
Yeah. Yeah, prap again.
Pameta. Pameta.
Yeah. We would say that.
Shimi so shpejti. So shpejti.
Say him. Same here.
Pasquale.
Shifemi sa manjere.
Sa manjere.
Lydia? And Peter, do you know how to say this?
Yeah, she and me would say like we'll see each other, like next tomorrow or yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mir, okay. Okay. Quindi shechemi.
Okay, shoot me. Shave me great.
See you.
Ciao.
Ciao, ciao, ciao.